Hello, everybody. You guys are going on my walk with me. I actually walk this road barefooted pretty much all the time, which is what I'm about to do. Everybody's used to just seeing my socks and my shoes on the side of the road. This is a little unusual live today. Like, what is she doing? Because I always want to step on the ground. I do this before every live. I just ground my feet. This is my little dirt road. Hi, Brittany. Hi, Sandra. I'm starting early today. Just doing some grounding. Oh, this isn't the beach. This is the desert. This isn't the beach. It's like a desert. But it feels like the beach when my feet are in the sand. Feels like I'm a million miles from nowhere and no place I'd rather be. So these dogs bark at me every time, same set of dogs. I asked the lady, what are your dogs' names? She's like, I'd rather not say. I said, oh, okay. You just gotta keep from stepping on goat heads because they hurt, and I mean like crazy. And everybody comes down the little dirt road in their truck. And I just stay over here walking my little dirt road. Taking my stuff with me. Hi, Michelle. Hi, Alex. Hi, everybody. Just eating my little apple. Walking on the earth. This is what I do. You guys always want to know, how do I do what I do? There's a lifestyle behind it. I studied the yamas and niyamas for a long time, which means the restraints and the observations. And I think that people definitely had their life saved by little trees like this in the desert, where it's just nothing but a little tree, but that might be the only break from the sun, and I mean a lot of sun. We're gonna walk back up the path. I'll let you guys. Hello, everybody. This is your One Tribe leader speaking to you from sunny, always sunny, Southern California. Oh, wrong glasses. Neighbors everywhere, they're used to the crazy lady that walks in her bare feet along the dirt road. I have to wait for it to cool down because it burned my feet. But I stand right over here and watch the sunset over the mountains. And I can't look at the sun directly, but through the phone I can. It's quite lovely. Isn't that pretty? Hi, Miss Wanda. Hi, Michelle. The dogs will stop barking in a minute. Sorry about that, y'all. Yeah, I've been a lot of places. In Georgia, where I'm from, it's very forested and green. This is a totally opposite climate. It's just a lot of dirt. Now, I do live close to the beach, but not at the beach. But in my mind, I'm anywhere I want to be. I might be in the middle of Bahamas. Y'all don't know. I could be anywhere. Look at my shoes, about to get run over by this guy going crazy, driving like a maniac. And there's my footprints. I always walk in the sand, in the deep sand, and try to find my footprints on the way back. Usually I walk pretty deep in the sand. And there's Sunshine's footprints. Every day I make a new set, and every day they're gone again. Just lets me know where I've been, right? You watch it every day? That's awesome. The sunset's a good way to end the day. It's a very good way to end the day. Ouch. That was something that stabbed me right in the foot. So, it's a little different today. We went on a hike this morning, me and the We Tribe, I call them. There's the One Tribe and the We Tribe. And the We Tribe are my progeny. I don't know if you guys know this, but we are a psychic family, so all my kids have gifts too. And my Instagram promoter is trying to get me to promote the kids on our own little Instagram called The Psychic Family. Yikes, and it's how I deal with each. This is the grossest. I don't like sticking my shoes in my feet with no socks. My shoes in my feet. My shoes on my feet. Bora Bora, okay. But anyway, my kids all have different gifts. So they want me to start featuring the kids on some of the programming. So I may start doing some videos of them because I have one that's a Claire. Let's see, what do we have? We have one that's an auric reader. He can see auras, although he doesn't do it anymore. He's in the Navy now. He's straight up and down scientific engineering field. And then we have, let's see, one is a precognitive clairvoyant, which can guess things before they happen, which is neat. And then we have one that's a telepath, which can always know when I send them something. They always get it. So I just project a number or a letter in my head or even a place. And he can always get it right. So he's definitely a telepath. And then the other ones, we have a precognitive, a telepath, and our energy reader. Miss Evanley can find things, so I'm pretty sure she's clairvoyant like me, because when something is missing, she can just find it. Like, just find it. It's amazing. She's like, I see it in my head, and I'm like, where is it? And she goes right to the spot where my earring or whatever is missing, and I'm like, that's so cool. Hi, Miss Emily. I'm walking through the field. This is a serious field. I wish I'd have bought this field. I was actually going to make a One Tribe Healing Center right here in front of my house. But someone bought the property. So I know it was the universe's way of telling me, it's not time and that's not what you're here for yet. I wish I could see y'all a little more. Hi, Tanya. Emily. Brittany. We were talking about having psychic kids. It's beautiful and hot. It's not hot right now. It's perfect temperature, actually. It's actually about the perfect temperature. And I'm excited. I just did a 24-hour nutritional juice fast. I feel amazing. I probably had like 6 pounds of vegetables and fruits go in my body. So my body is a happy camper right now. I had to actually be hungry today, which was cool. So I got to eat some yogurt and fruit, and I'm eating some other stuff for dinner. So I wonder if we should go through the studio. No, let's just go to the house. Hello, everybody. Hello. All right, here's Maverick. You guys remember Maverick? My truck, that's a little, you know. My truck is gay. I didn't take him back. I know that he was built that way. I appreciate him and love him just the way he is. There's my sticker. To let everybody know, just in case they didn't know, that they were out trucked by a girl. And he's dirty right now. Who's a dirty boy? Who's a dirty boy? He's got his little glamour. He's got his little glamour on. All right, let's go to the yard. Let's see what's in our yard today. There's my lilies that I like to grow. And my sprinklers, which are on. And that's the tree I sit under over there with a little tree swing. And there's my cat, Einstein, which is, of course, a girl. And then I have wee little kitty somewhere. Let's see you, Karma. Karma, Karma, Karma. Let's see my dog who loves me. Loves me more than my kids, I'm pretty sure. Karma, do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? Oh my goodness, Karm Karm. Hi, Troubles. Hi, Karm Karm. Oh goodness, Carmax. Oh, Carmelia. Oh, Carmageddon. Oh, you're such a good girl. Can't let you out right now, though. Because we've got the kitties. What's about to happen? Oh, it's perfectly silent. Nice and quiet. Smells good. There's my old table I got from the lady at the estate sale, my 100-year-old table, which I put my tablecloth on. Thought that was neat. And there's my picture I got from the estate sale, which I love. Yeah, that's my karma. my CarMax. And it smells like food in here. And it looks like food in here. And I'm going to go right on by that. Oh, I can't see a thing. I look like a giant bug. Hello, everybody. This is the Africa room, which you can't see much. And then nobody gets to see my room. It is a dungeon. It's a dungeon of secrets. We're going to turn my AC on. Oh, there we go. And we're back in the studio. Look at this time travel. We were here, we were there, and now we are everywhere. Okay. Let's see what we got going on, you guys. All right, I am with you. Let's turn all of our lights on. Dun, 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 dun. Hello, everybody. We're going on this nice walk. We're going to hang out a little bit. Yeah, that's karma. Boy, that light there is like a little too much. Let me turn that off. All right. Hi, Miss Marianne. Look at this hair. It's all going up. It's all going wild. So we figured out on the last live that no one can share the content unless they're my friends. So we're going to have to figure out. I just hired a company today. They're going to see if they can get into our old pages, which would be the Spiritual Intuitive, Sunshine Frost. We're going to see if we can get into those old pages, because if we can, then we don't have to start another business page. If we cannot, then I will be starting another business page, and it will be linked to the new Instagram and YouTube accounts together. My Instagram won't change. It'll still be the Seer of Light. Hi, Kathy. So today I'm not going to do a whole lot of readings right this session, but I do want to talk about something which is discouraging. I want to hear what's going on with the tribe and what has been your challenge today. What is your challenge been? I know my challenge. What is your challenge? Hi, Chrissy. Hello, everybody. Brittany, Marianne. Let's share this to the people we do know that are our friends. Let's go ahead and share this live broadcast to those people that are our friends. I hired a company out of New York City. They deal with a lot of these Facebook issues. Let's just put it that way. Let's not get crazy. Let's just say Facebook issues. Please share this. And make sure also that you are signing up for notifications. This is going to be a temporary business page as we get the new one started, but we're going to make sure we make a valiant effort to get into the old one before we do anything new. I don't want to lose something just for the sake of losing it. And we're going to be doing more lifestyle content, so make sure. Let's see what we have to say. Make sure that you are, yeah, low energy. It's rough, isn't it? That's your challenge today, my dear. All right, Brandy, low energy. They're showing me carbs. You must metabolize carbs very quickly and then you're hungry again for something like bread or fruit or pasta. It shows me that you are very carb sensitive and that you metabolize sugar extremely fast. So you're always kind of tired, but you're also hungry. So there's a fatigue going on there. Florida or Alabama? Why do I feel like you have family in Alabama, Miss Brittany? But Florida would be more fun. I do like me some Bama, though. Hi, Carrie Ann. Trying not to be upset over not seeing my this week and still needing a car. Not seeing my, oh, daughter, probably your daughter this week, Veronica. Yeah. Working out when the weather is crappy. Let me tell you what. That is actually, I work out in my studio. I'm going to show you guys what I do. I quit going to the gym 6 months ago. I'm in better shape now than I ever was then. I'm going to show you how I did that. We're going to start sharing some lifestyle tips and stuff. You guys are going to get to see more of my kids. I posted my very first, probably my first kid video, my kid pictures on my Facebook today. Did you guys get a chance to see that? Very hard month. Fell down all day. Yeah. helping stepsister through depression. It's okay, Kathy. Give her a minute, sweetie. No patience. Hopefully my food was okay to eat. Hi, Corey. Florida, actually. That's where I feel you. Florida, definitely. I've been feeling so unwell and so much pain lately. Oh, no. Daughter, yes. Shared. Hi, Sarah. Hi, Corey. Yeah, it was really nice. I took the kids hiking. I'm like, I'm the teacher. I'm the teacher now. I homeschool them, so I'm the teacher now. And what's the best thing to teach? It's not what you say. It's getting up off your butt and doing whatever you say you're going to do. So I'm like, we need to do this. We need to try this. We need to do that. And they're like, Mom, you can't do that from your bed. And I'm like, really? Let's go. That's it. We're all hiking. I think the way to solve this is a brisk 2-mile hike. That's going to solve a lot of these problems. And it's amazing how they went from fighting with each other to completely at peace on the way back. Ah, snow angels, the challenge is cleaning it all up. Oh my gosh, it's so hard. They've done that to me so many times. No, you're sweet and you love children. No, Miss Brandy, that message was for Brittany. She's deciding whether to move to Alabama or Florida. So that was for her. I had yours was the carb sensitive one about burning through sugars and feeling very low energy. Try not to be negative and acting like a victim, thinking things will change without putting effort in, remembering to show up for my own life. Narrative. Narrative, narrative, narrative. I'm about to put my face on in front of you guys. You ready for this? Who is this going to bother? I had another medium friend. She's like, why do you put your makeup on live? That is just so tacky. And I thought, well, maybe some vegan makeup company will want to sponsor me. Who knows? No. Because it's just time to do a little lippy. This is no makeup. You guys always see me with a little bit of makeup. I don't wear much. But we're going to do a little. Why not? It's good. A little paint on the barn. Hey, Google. Play Grow by Satsang. I actually got so much sun, my powder's too light. I can see it. I can't see you guys. Give me a second. You see me all squinting. I'm like little squint queen. Hey, Google, turn up. This is pretty much all I do. You're going to see what I do. It's not a whole lot, honestly. Maybe this isn't the right song. Hey, Google, play Between.
Okay, In Between by Scotty McCreery.
Oh, that's not what I was looking for. And then I blend. Hey, Google, play Satsang's Between. Hi, Ian. What's up, Yonski? I need some. Do you? Well, didn't Dad just make tacos or something?
I dropped like some white chips or something.
I don't think I have any. Why is my Google being so haunted today, Ian? What number am I thinking of? Hey, Google. Play Green Mountain State by Trevor Hall. I want one, maybe.
Green Mountain State by Trevor Hall.
I think I want one, Ian. Music. I don't know where your hands have been.
I just washed them.
I know. Yeah, I always hear that from you guys. Yeah, you're live. Chips are so good. Will you bring Mama some water, please? Please? I don't think you will.
Yes.
Will you? He came back to call me out. He's like, yes, I will. Yes. Yes.
Do you live inside, outside me?
That's it. That's not much. Putting a little paint on the barn. And I got this eyeliner, but you're supposed to do 40 coats to make your eyelashes look like you have spiders on them. I don't have time for that mess. I have a real job, okay? I work. They're like, yeah, you look like you work in sunshine. At least I don't do this. Like a fish. All right, that's about as good as it's going to get, y'all. Maybe a little of this business. A little bit of that. Yay. Now I can put my eyeballs back on and see what y'all had to say about me. All right. Oh, that's not helping. Lord have mercy, I dried with my hair wet. What is this? What is that? That's going to bother me. I'm going to actually wet my hands and make my bangs lay down. And obey me. Obey me, I say. I am the boss of these bangs, not you. You guys ever had those days when your hair's like, oh, you think you're the boss? Let me show you what's up. Look at that. Look at that business. Rink. Okay. Would you guys tell me if I look like something about Mary my entire...
Fresh water, I swear, no peach, no nothing.
Look at that. Would you tell me if I look like something about Mary? There's a way. You miss your babies every day, they grow up. I know, I love mine. I miss my older one. But I just got off the phone with them. He's like super involved. I'm sorry, Christy. Your mom passed 2 years ago. My mom passed about, gosh, there's no help for these things. It doesn't, if I go up, that looks good, and then there's not enough down, and yikes. Ugh. This is the stuff that y'all don't see behind the camera, me trying to tame my hair. I'm about to let it all down. I'm about to shake it around and just leave it alone. You do my makeup live, it's fun. Oh, do I want to have people on live tonight? Methinks I do. Ha! Thank you, Helen. Oh, Valerie, I'm so glad. You're heading to soccer? I wish my kids were going to soccer. I wish they'd go to something so I could get out of the house. That'd be lovely. We're still locked down. Thank you, Margarita, you sweet thing. You were bidding on a house today. Don't think I even want that house now. Kathy? It's nothing to do with you. This is a process, and I'm not sure that was the right house. You guys ready? I'm just letting Mufasa breathe. And I did it again. No shampoo, again, just rice water. I rinsed it with just rice water. No oils, no nothing. No, I have not washed my hair now in like a month. It's just clean all the time. It's amazing. Hey, Katie girl. Corey's known me since I was like 13. Have I needed makeup, Corey? Have I always worn makeup? I'm a Southern girl. Like, we are supposed to just touch up a little. Southern women believe two things. Hide your crazy, shut your mouth, be a lady, and powder it up a little bit. Okay. I'm gonna be serious right now. I'm gonna be like Dear Abby, okay? Y'all ready? I'm gonna be like Dear Abby. I could be like a psychic guru and make you guys like listen to me because I'm going to get the creepy low voice. You guys remember my creepy voice? Carrie Ann says, I'm feeling so much pain and exhaustion like someone has pushed a button and drained me. They have, but you're allowing them to. Even in all circumstances, we have a choice about the narrative we tell ourselves. Hey Google, put on Liquid Mind meditation music. You have a choice about the narrative you're telling yourself. So if you feel exhausted, that means that you're pushing yourself to do for people and your motivation and passion really isn't there. It's better for you to say no than for you to say yes and not mean it. Hi, Tony. You like fish? I don't even know where that came from. I like fish. Where did that come from? Oh, the fish face. Depression is a big thing these days. Do you know why depression is a big thing? Do you know why depression is a big thing? Because we all think our life is supposed to be something it's not. We tell ourselves a narrative. When the narrative doesn't line up with what's happening, we become depressed because we're like, why is this not going the way I thought it would go? Why is this not happening? I'm trying to prop you guys up. Don't pay attention. When that doesn't happen, guess what? When that does not happen, sorry, I gotta do something. Everybody's like, you're so real. Yeah, too real. Sometimes. We're setting up a new studio out in the actual studio, the Soul Palette, so you won't get these you won't get these blooper reels anymore. You won't get all these really cute blooper reels. Everything's gonna look more tidy. Oh gosh, that's too much light. Not enough light. Hi Jake. Hi Jimmy. Hello England. It's my realness is refreshing. I'm sure if I could edit out some of it. Nah, probably not. So if you're telling yourself a narrative like, damn, this year was supposed to be so much better than it was. Like, what the hell happened? I had big plans this year. I was going to be doing live retreats. I was already supposed to be in England. I was already supposed to be in Canada. All this stuff happened. But COVID was like, yeah. Sit on it. Wait. Because guess what? COVID is a wonderful thing for empaths because it's going to teach you how to be able to block negativity, whether it be political negativity, media negativity. It's going to teach you how to block that stuff so that you're not constantly being embedded with it in your subconscious. And it's going to help you to be more telepathic because since you're not communicating with everyone every day, we're communicating through things like these chats and video. It's going to make you more of a subtle receiver for energy because now you're like, you know, I picked up that you weren't feeling so good. Whereas before you had so many things going on, you were really busy and you didn't have time for that. Now guess what? You have time for that. Are your finances going to get better? Yes, Sandra, but I don't see it like right away. I see that after the beginning of the year. My son says that about the hair, no shampoo. Well, I wouldn't just stop shampooing my hair. I mean, I do clean it, but I'm using rice water and now I'm on, this is gonna be the fourth week of rice water and I love it. It's good stuff. So I think I'm gonna do a little video on it, but it'll be on my Instagram page, not on Facebook because my Instagram is lifestyle. So we're gonna start doing things about psychic kids, like videos of my kids and the gifts they have, what they do, how I keep them safe. What kind of things do I do with them if they have nightmares or see spirit or deal with that? Hi, Wendy. Hi, Teresa. Hi, Marnie. Marnie, you know I like that, Marnie. Vanessa, my Nessie bear. Teresa, Galen. Hi, sweetie. Feel like the world is filled with empaths and narcissists. How did things become so polarized? They were always polarized. That's just now we labeled it. There's always been a polarity. Go back 100 years and look at what they did to women. Go back 200 years, look what they did to witches. For 725 years, look what they did around the world to the empaths and the healers. They were always narcissists. They ran the countries. They decided that they would go in and take resources and people and make things their way or no way. It's always been that way. Crystal, you always ask me if I had a good day. I freaking love you. Hey, Sunshine, my family and I are quarantined. Our daycare provider tested positive for COVID, so I have to get tested tomorrow. So I return to work. Hope all is well. Our county is a hot spot right now. Let me explain. I've been here since January. I have not went to anywhere. My kids have not been out of the house except to go to the park one time. We haven't eaten a restaurant. We haven't been to a library. We haven't been able to go to a school. We haven't had a play center, no daycares. Literally nothing has been opened. I waited like 3 months just to buy a pair of shoes. Brittany, you're scared for surgery on Wednesday. Let me tell you why. The ego body is always afraid of change, and the ego is always afraid that something will happen to it. Because the reality is the ego can die with the body, but the soul never does. So just ask that the universe and your guides only allow that which is for your highest and best good to serve you on this mission. And recognize, remember to heart, comment, and share content. Remember that it's very important to recognize that your body is going to be healed and you're only afraid of things that haven't happened. So you're afraid of the what ifs. You don't even know what the what if is. And so fear is an imagined reality that isn't real. So don't be afraid of something that hasn't happened, okay? You're just gonna make yourself twice as scared. That light was too much. Carrie Ann, we've never done a session, but I would love to. It's like you're gonna need surgery on that area, Miss Carrie Ann. Or did you have surgery on that where that gland swells up? Thank you. Thank you so much, Helen. Yeah, you have to choose negativity. People think, oh, I don't choose it. It's always there. Bullshit. You do choose it. You choose either to block it, to acknowledge it, or to even give energy to it. I don't give energy to that garbage. Everybody says, Facebook's so negative. I just can't believe it. And I'm like, I get on my Facebook and I don't see a single negative thing. I had 4,800 friends. I never saw a negative post. I never saw cursing. I never saw negativity. I never saw violent behavior. I never saw any of that because people never thought that I would appreciate that type of garbage being sent to me. And I never saw it. Honest to God, I never saw it. Hi, Raina. Your husband has nightmares about demons. I sage it and it gets better for a while. Those are more coming from inside of him during times of great stress. I feel like he grinds his teeth, like he grits, he bears down with his teeth as well, and his back jaws and stuff, and he has head pain. He gets like headaches, Miss Sherry, for your husband. This goes back to the childhood. And we could do an energy clearing and you can be present and I can show you how to help him clear that so he doesn't have to keep reoccurrently going through it. Hi, Priya, my yaya girl. Hi, Sunny, I love you. Hi, Carla, you just came across me last week. Your positive has helped me so much. The last 6 months have been very difficult for me. My sister passed May 9th. Oops. My mom passed July 13th and my dad passed September 23rd. Miss Carla, you really have taken on a lot of karma in this life. You are amazing. To take on that much at one time, you are a really special and blessed soul to be able to not only handle that, but for God to feel that you could handle that. The universe knowing that you need to be so in tune with yourself. I'm wearing black, you guys. I never wear black for y'all. You must be so in tune with yourself. Miss Carla, there is a real loving energy around you and real loving spirit, and they talk about birthdays. So they said there's four of those, but she says there's birthdays. So it's like, do you have children or grandchildren that like share those, like the birthdays are in the summer and then you lost them like four, but there's four of you left too. You're just amazing soul. Hi, Rhonda. Yeah, it's like almost like an abscess or something that is not quite right and I can't figure it out, but it's almost like it's a lymph node nodule. Yes, Miss Raina. Hi, Kathleen. When you see black cats, what is the meaning behind it? Well, I actually think black cats are very lucky and I own one named Salem. And I own another black cat, and his name is Kylo. And I know that the black cat actually, in my Nordic traditions of being a Volvir of the pale-faced tribes of the north, of the lands of ice and snow where I originate, actually our goddess name is Freya. And Freya, she walked with two big black cats, and that is where her magic was sown. And the theories of the witches with the black cat came from the Nordic Volvir, which is the fearsome, very powerful, strong woman of the north. And she had two big, beautiful black cats with her. And that's why they became known as the familiars of a witch. And so therefore, to me, black cats are extremely lucky. And in the land of Ireland, in the Celtic tradition, the bog cat was a black type of panther. And they made black cat emblems. And only women of the tribes, the wise women like the Volvir, would carry those black cats. And so actually, it means something very, very lucky if you cross the path of a black cat. It wasn't until St. Patrick came along around 700 BC, and decided that when he saw the women with the black cats, that there had to be black magic existing in those times. And so therefore, they created a rumor that black cats were not only dangerous, but unlucky. And so they decided to put them to death. and that has followed them along their ways. Okay. You're welcome. It's okay if you miss part. You can watch it, Miss Kathleen. I want to talk to you guys about All Hallows Eve, and I'm going to debunk the biggest myths about what Halloween really should look like if you want it to be a special holiday in your house. Now that we have made it untraditional, we're not going out and just begging for candy at neighbors' houses. I would love to tell you what Halloween really means. Are you guys ready to hear some of this? I think we should wait until, let's see, what is today? Today is the 19th. I leave on Friday to go on vacation. I'll be up in the mountains. I'm taking my big truck and my big trailer, and I'm going to go up to the woods. I'm off for the entire week. I have no sessions this week. I'm just enjoying my time. I'm kayaking, I'm hiking, I'm walking. I am going to be up in the mountains. I'm going to enjoy everything, and I'm going to be painting, and I'm designing and working on the One Tribe clothing line, which I'm super excited about. I couldn't be more excited. I'm really thrilled about that. I can't wait to get that stuff out. I gotta plug you guys in somehow. Anyway, so we can talk about Halloween and what that really means to you. Let me plug you guys in. Give me just a second. We were gonna have a One Tribe Halloween party. You guys remember that? That's where we dress up in all of our tribal stuff. And we're gonna do a Zoom Halloween party. So rather than being live, we'll be on Zoom, and that way you can dress up in your costume and share with the tribe what you look like, what tribe you're from, or anything that you'd like to try to share with us. Helen, part of that is the healing process. Hi, Lisa. Hi, Regine. Hi, Washington. I'm trying to find my way back to where I should be. I just got a bergamot and sage candle. Let me tell you, Miss Wanda, that's an illusion. That's an illusion. There is no getting back to where you should be. Whatever your detour was part of your path as well. And when people think that they're only supposed to be doing things the way they're supposed to be, there is an illusion in that, because even all of your, how do I put this? All of your struggles, your adversity, and your challenges, even with me, look what's happened. I worked hard for these two pages, and now they're just flatlined, and I'm starting over. It's a gift. It's a blessing. I get a chance to rebrand this in a new way that's going to be easy to find. We get a chance to simulcast YouTube and Facebook together. And there's just so many blessings to it when you look at it from that perspective. But wherever your detour took you, Miss Wanda, you were meant to be there. I have a black cat named Salem. I do. I love him. Oh, you know what? You have a black grand kitty named Binks. We have another black long-haired solid black cat named Jinx. Hello, my first time you met or saw my name, my dentist medium, you're beautiful. Aw, thank you, Lisa. Yes, me and him are very good friends. We're brothers in the One Tribe. To the person whose husband has headaches due to sunshine, says grinding his teeth, I'm in the dental field, and one thing you can do before the husband goes to bed is take a wet hand towel and, yes, loosen up his masseter muscle. And again, before he even drinks coffee in the morning, it's the least invasive way to help with the effects of grinding. I think he's grinding his teeth because of his stress. You said, yes, they said nodulated. Will they fix it? It hurts so bad. You always lift my mood. Yes, Carrie Ann, a nodulated thyroid. You just have a lot of, all of your nerves run there, baby. Of course they can fix that. It's not hard. In fact, I have another biopsy for cancer. So my third cancer biopsy, I keep telling them, I don't have it. We're good. We're straight. But I have another one where they're going to go into my thyroid. They're checking both sides for cancerous nodules. It is what it is. I don't worry about it. I've put it off like four times. So now I'm like, okay, just do it. Get it over with so they'll stop calling. Sherry said, I've had several migraines within the past couple of weeks. I can't find the trigger. The trigger is stress and caffeine. My son's birthday is 2 days after my mom's. My other one shares his birthday with the brother that passed at birth. That's right, Carla. So what I'm really saying is, and this may not be what you're used to hearing, but you're freaking amazingly blessed to have so many angelic guides on the other side. Each one of you has your own angel guide. Is that not amazing? What is going on? You're so blessed, Miss Carla. You're so blessed that all your loved ones are on the other side. So in my family, my grandmother and grandfather that raised me are gone. My brother is gone. My mother is gone. My aunts and uncles I lived with growing up are on the other side. So the only people I have left are two remaining relatives on the whole planet. That's it. If you could search the whole thing, and my sister. So I have three. Sorry. Sorry, my sister. I forgot about you. You have a tuxedo kitty? Ha. Thank you, Catherine. At least it's good to be good at something. I was in an orphanage for almost four years, and I was never adopted. So in that time, I read a lot of books. Books for my friend, and I even have a shirt that says, "You're never alone if you have books." So I studied a lot of books. And then I got a chance to get on scholarship to medical school at Brigham Young University, and I got to study there. And then I went on and got another degree in surgical technology and one in emergency medicine. And I did another one, and I was finishing my nursing. And so I got a chance to learn quite a lot of things. And I gave it all up just to be an art teacher and hypnotherapist, and then decided to go into this beautiful gift. So it's been a really fun experience learning to teach. Hi, Lisa from California. Hi, Ms. Jackie. You have my session with you tomorrow night at 7. That's right. I do have a session with you tomorrow night at 7. I do remember you, Ms. Kathleen. Recharge those batteries in nature, sunshine. That's what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm getting to go up to Julian, which is a beautiful place. It's up in the mountains, which I love the forest. I love the mountains. I've just made it my goal that at the end of the day is when I do my lives. So I've chose that on Instagram, I'm going to be doing that in the morning. So you're going to start getting inspirational tips, wisdom, tricks. I'm going to share you guys my green juices, some of the exercise equipment I use at home. I don't use my gym membership anymore. Some of the things I do, just some of the things I do in my lifestyle, right? Because I live a certain lifestyle, and that allows me to be able to do a massive amount of energy work. And I find a lot of energy workers, and they're like, how are you able to do it on this scale, you know, 20, 50 hours a week, and you seem fine? And I say, there is a way to it, and there's a way not to do it, and I want to help you find your true north. I'm excited for the kids to get out of the house. We haven't left the house for, you know, 6-8 months now. So to get to take them somewhere, except for we went to Georgia and back. You guys were with me on that trip, but this will be the first time since then. Maggie, your daughter-in-law died on Halloween. You're raising two of her children. Well, then I would love to share with you the actual real traditions. And you hear me talking my Nordic vulvar voice. The Nordic traditions of the North, where you get to really enjoy the Hallows Eve. When the souls cross the spirit bridge and are with you, how do you honor them and make them know that they are loved? So that's a great way. I'll teach you how to love and honor her, and how to teach your two grandchildren or children how to really enjoy and appreciate Halloween, because really what it is Christmas for all the souls on the other side, and it's just been commercialized into a really disgusting holiday that I don't even celebrate Halloween at all, but I do celebrate All Hallows Eve and the harvest. So I celebrate the two things that God gave us, which was the opportunity to have a very thin veil between this world and your loved ones on the other side, and how we can really learn to appreciate and honor those spirits. So, very cool stuff. I know I'm so far up, you guys, but I like to read every comment. I need to lose weight again. I'm going to my daughter's house. She's having a small get-together Halloween. Don't worry. I promise you that I'm doing another shoot tomorrow, and this is going to be all about the healthy lifestyle and how I lost the 60 pounds and what it looks like, what it feels like, and how easy it was to do it. And I promise you, I am going to start sharing those tips with you. Brittany, I love you. I'm sending you love, and I want you to know everything is working out for your highest and best good. I feel you really drawn to Florida, but it's like, is there a job offer in Alabama? Because there's a reason Alabama's on the list. Darlene, you are on your path, but you've had a lot of difficult. They showed me three big difficulties in the last year. It's okay. We're all going through that. We're like, our whole lives have been put in a blender, and they just they press like 1, 2, 3, 4, freaking warp speed, and then COVID. COVID-19 was like the. Regine, is my son mad at me for not being with him when he passed on? I have not felt him in nearly 4 years. The answer to that question is no. He's not angry. He's not mad. And the only person blocking him from coming to you is your guilt at not allowing him to not forgive. You have an issue of unforgiveness. And he's not angry with you because his angels and guides were with him. And he also had a male here on this side and a grandmother on the other side. I think it's a great grandmother that was with him. You have a short haired cat named Spock. That's so cute. Sunshine, I miss my aunt so much. I prepared myself as much as I could before her passing, but it seems unbearable. Do you happen to know where she is at her journey? She's with your family members, love. She's so happy with your family members. I have a blessing with all these. I know, thank you, Katie, and I know you're going to help me, and I'm going to see you again. I love you guys. A black kitty. Sunshine, could you connect with my husband, Brian Arrigo's stepsister? Only if Brian, if I was doing this session for Brian, I can put you guys in a group session and I can do one and then the other, yes. I've done 5 people in a row in one family. I've done readings back to back to back. I just need to get up, get water, stretch, clear, go back and start again. Aw, that's awesome. I promise when I have money, I am booking a long session. Until then, I will watch and share to grow the community. Feel bad, I always tune in but can't get a session. No. You do not have to pay to get a session. This is not about monetizing the gift. The gift is a free gift. It works through me. It is not me. And you have the same gift, sweetheart. You are psychic. Everyone is psychic. Not everyone is a medium. And I promise you, we're getting our webcasting stuff this week. And I'm going to start getting those classes together. So even if you can't afford a reading, this is why I do this work. It's because it's a ministry of my soul. To be able to help you guys, because I know, like I said, I feel like Jesus when he wept for those with compassion, because I see what's on the other side. I see your loved ones, I see your angels, I see your guides, and I see them guiding you in perfect love and light every day. And it is my gift to share that with you because I have love for the world. And I know, if the world saw what I saw, they would believe and understand and have understanding like I have. So when you understand more, you see more, you love more, and it helps you to forgive more and move on to help others. My Instagram is the Seer of Light. The Seer of Light. Thank you, Michelle. Tanya, I will pray for you that lost your job. Brittany, you have no determination to stay on a healthy diet. I'm not always on a healthy diet, but I program my food, and that's the difference. I'm going to show you guys. What I do is not a diet. It is a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle of the love frequency. It's about programming the food, and as we program you, you're going to learn to program your food. It's going to make everything so much easier, I promise. All right. Not everybody has drive and determinations. You don't have to have it all the time. Hi, Missy. Brittany, can you put that link up there, Raina? I don't know if I have my own link or not. Let me see. Okay, let me put my link up real quick. If you guys would like to book a session, please book for next week, not this week. Let's see what we have to say. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Arizona, please tell me, are my angels with me and who are they? Thank you. So Missy, it froze because I left the page. I just came back. And the reason that you don't know your angels' names is because it's not important. And I tell people this constantly. You don't have to know the name of your angels because angels do not want to be worshipped or glorified. They worked by the will of God. And they work in legion armies like Gabriel, Uriel, Michael. There's so many angels and so many angel armies that angel is like, it's like saying they're a mail carrier. It's their job. Every time an angel appeared in the Bible, people, humans would fall down and worship them because of their great beauty and power. And the angels would always say, no, I come in peace, but I come to represent the Holy One of Israel, or the highest God. The glory to God in the highest, right? So angels don't want to be worshipped. So when you pray to angels, it makes no difference whether you pray. You don't have to pray directly to your angels. You can say simple like, I need my guardians to watch over me. I need angels to heal me. I need angels to watch over my children. There isn't a right or wrong way to call on angels. You can just picture an angel in your head. That sends the vibration of telepathic thought. You can do it in your heart. You can call out to them, like I have many times. Called out to angels many, many times because I was struggling. So you can definitely call on them when you need help. Ask for help with that job. Ask for help with people that have passed. Ask for help with your children. Crystal, there's something going on with her diet. I almost feel like she's celiac or wheat. She has a leaky gut. That's part of her issue, Crystal. I think you need to remove her from all gluten. Courtney, you want advice on what I should do to be on my path to the best life, my way to... Let me explain something that's going to blow your mind. You ready? Sometimes the best... Let me get some water. My tongue is tied up. Sometimes the best path you can be on in this life... Your actual true and correct life path is not an easy one. Sometimes the best, most productive, and effective life path is not an easy one. Sometimes we're not here to gain, I call it the free hot dog, right? We're not here for the easy stuff. There's no learning in that. Sometimes we're made to suffer and be in circumstances and situations of irony and pain and contradiction and difficulty and lack. And I don't mean that all the time, but I mean there's paths in life, and we chose those before we came, and the reason we're going through them is for the learnings. So people will say, man, I just need to get on my path. I need to get on my path. And I'm like, yeah, get on your path, get on your path. And they're like, what is it? And I'm like, you're on it. And they're like, but this path is hell. It's like, damn, it's just pure hell. And I'm like, yep, you're still on the path. They're like, how could I come down here and choose that? And I'm like, you didn't. You chose it when you were up there before you knew what suffering or compassion or frustration or loneliness or anger or starvation. You didn't know what any of that even meant in a place with no want at all. So that's usually where people come from. But even if it's difficult, that doesn't mean you're not on your path. All right, so I'm going to do my link right now to book a session again. I did it. Okay, so it's Sunshine, it's the Seer of Light. Sunshine Frost, I think it's Sunshine Frost. Let me see if I can grab. All right, guys, I'm back. Sorry, I'm going to go ahead and post that. How do I clipboard that right here? Let's see if I can post that in there. Can you share that, or how do I share that? I don't know if I just did. Instagram, the Seer of Light. I always say that when I'm mad that I wish I was never born. Lol, oh man, I just feel everything on my shoulders. You know, you chose that, Brittany. You chose that. Let's get out of the narrative of victimization. Let's say that we chose this shit. It's a good thing. And if you're stuck for a long time, Courtney, it's because you haven't learned the lesson, so the karmic cycle is repeating. Simone, I don't think the problem is with you as much as it is with your partner, Miss Simone. I feel like there is a low sperm count. Have you tested him before you test yourself? Because there's two of you that are fertile. 11-11 means you're on your perfect path. I remember breaking down the side of the road with my bullshit car, and I had to... I had to put the window down and stick my hand out to get a Happy Meal because it was so embarrassing. I couldn't even open the window. I had to, like, open the door from the outside, and my window had to be rolled up and with a garbage bag. And my son, my little five-year-old, was taking the Happy Meal and paying through the back window because it's the only one that worked. I remember thinking, like, man, this is bullshit. I need to get on my real path. I need to be living my real life. And I looked at the freaking clock, and my air conditioner wasn't working in South Georgia. I was hot as hell. And I kicked the dash, and the clock got stuck on 11:11. And I'm like, are you freaking kidding me? This is my path. This bullshit is my path. But guess what? It was. It really, really was my path. And I'm so glad I took it. Tanya, your husband didn't pass on Halloween because it was Halloween. That just was coincidental. Hi, Bree, my wifey. Teresa Marie, you have depression for as long as you can remember, even as a small child. Why? Well, I'd have to get into your head to know the real reason for that, but there's a couple of things, which is programming and reframing. Because there was something about that childhood that made you feel that you were not really loved and impressed upon, that you were special and meaningful, and you've carried those limiting beliefs through your life. Hi, Janet. I'm glad you're here. Janet, do you have a male on the other side? So true. Here to learn lessons. I want to learn the I know. Learn the lessons and quit recycling, you guys. I'm sorry, Miss Anne Marie. Your dad passed and then your mom gave up too. I love you too, Nessa. Yeah, playing the victim is never helpful. I mean, let me put it this way. Play the victim, but do it to your only your closest friends and family, because be honest, no damn body else wants to hear it. And the sad thing is, nobody wants to hear it. Like, even when you really need to talk about it, there is a very, if you have five people to talk, I mean, I'm going to say if you have three, you're lucky as hell. You are lucky as hell if you got five people that want to hear your bad day and your bad news, because they've all got bad news and bad stuff too. You got to choose who you're going to be in this life. If you're going to get in the ditch with them and help heap the dirt on them, or if you're going to be somebody different and get the shit off of them and wash them off and say, what are you doing? I have, and nothing has happened for months, or I should just give up trying. It's frustrating. Simone, you checked your male partner's sperm and he's fine? Brandy Joe, are you dealing with something that feels like autoimmune disease? Because I'm literally feeling like Epstein-Barr, or even like, this could be like Epstein-Barr virus, or because they don't test for Epstein-Barr, and it comes up a lot. Not a lot, but I do sense it occasionally, and it would be like Lyme's, because it's weird. Your symptoms are unusual. Your faith tends to double during a crisis? Hell yeah, because there's a thing called foxhole prayers. People don't pray very good when they're not... You know what a foxhole is? Back in World War I, World War II, they'd be fighting on a battlefield, right? They dig out these little pits, right? The first soldier would go dig out the pit, and they'd probably shoot him as he was digging it. So then the next soldier would make it to that one, lay low for a while, and make it a little further, dig another little hole. The battlefield was, like, riddled with these little foxholes, as they call them. Sometimes they go under the ground. They basically dig a tunnel, like a little rabbit under the ground. They say the most sincere prayers is when using a foxhole. So sometimes people come and they say, well, I prayed and prayed and prayed, nothing happened. And I say, that's a foxhole prayer, because you know damn well you wouldn't have been praying if you wasn't under heavy fire from every direction. And if there was any other way but spiritual, you'd have done it. You'd have got your ass out of there. But because you chose to be spiritual this one time and you prayed to God, you want him to automatically start jumping down like a miracle worker, rearranging your crappy life because you made terrible choices. Let's be real, people. Let's be real. It is 6:29 where I'm at. Ha! Yes, they were, Veronica. I'm getting a tattoo soon. I feel it's the right symbol for me, but not sure. I've put it off for a while, but it feels like it's time. Honey, if you're not sure, don't do it. That stuff is on you for life. That is a lifelong commitment. Just make sure you're in love with it, because you better love it, and you better love it I mean, all the time, every day. All my tattoos, they're on my back, so I ain't got to look at them every day. I want so bad to learn the lesson and what I am doing wrong. Okay, first of all, Courtney, you're not doing a damn thing wrong. You automatically assume something's wrong because your life is not, you know, falling out of Pinterest, or you're not some sort of Orange County housewife, baby. Your life could be still good and meaningful and on the right path and still hard. This shit isn't easy. If it was, the angels would come down and do it. It's not easy. It's not easy. Human life is not easy. It's not meant to be easy. If it was easy, the angels would be down here and we'd be up there giving them advice. Hi, Neralis. My best friend is worried about her boyfriend. He's been missing for a week. He struggles with mental illness. She fears the worst. Is he okay? I feel like there's drugs involved. Like he's around some druggy people and just kind of held up with them. Is he had a history of drug past? Yes, Janet. Is your son passed, or is this a grandson, Janet? Who's the young male? Handsome? My son was diagnosed with cancer. Please explain why this is happening. You sure picked an easy topic there, Margarita. I was like just breezing through this whole live, and you're like, my son got cancer. Give me a reason why. Let me tell you what. A world-renowned cancer doctor, oncologist, working in pediatric oncology for Loma Linda University or the Mayo Clinic can't tell you why somebody gets cancer. Because there's about 100,000 good reasons why people get cancer. From holding stress and anxiety to exposure to asbestos. I've done thousands of readings with cancer patients. And out of thousands of them, I can only tell you about 500 reasons why people get cancer. And it's usually due to some sort of exposure to water, heavy metals. There's aspartame, there's in utero effects of what you used on your body or pills while you were pregnant. There is literally no way to tell your son why he has cancer. The one thing I do know is the answer is the same. None of us know when we're going to stay, and none of us know when we're going to go to the other side. He may have signed up for that challenge while he was here. So the best way to handle that is to use healing Reiki on him, keep a positive mental mindset, adjust the diet to be the healthiest, most nutritionally dense foods that he can eat, keep him happy, live as loving and joyfully as you can. Because I spent 25 rounds in the chemo ward in the last 18 months ago. I spent 25 rounds sitting in a chemo ward 30 hours a week. And I played my drum. I played the Native American flute, which I am garbage at. I'm terrible at it. It sounds like a cat being skinned backwards. It's horrible. But I still did it. I was playing that flute just like I was Pan, just dancing a snake up out the basket. I was doing all that. And you know what? People in the cancer ward loved it because my energy was good. All right. Huh. People won't listen to people. No joke. I have two people I go to event to have less. Yes, yes, yes. Why do I always feel so lost all the time? I want to be by myself. Because you're an empath and you're picking up on two realms of thought. You're picking up on the actual physical secular world, and then you're picking up on the energetic world, and then you don't like people and you got to be away from them. Yeah, I do the same thing. I got to be in my room for a while. Oh, your husband was with you? He's very handsome, kind of lighter hair. He's always around you. Neralis. Okay, Nora. Was your boyfriend, I swear this has to do with drugs, and I don't want to say that, I'm not trying to shame anybody, but it feels like the people he was with were like drug users. Carrie Ann, I have constant nightmares, sometimes my dreams come true, what's wrong with me? Why you gotta assume something's wrong with you? You're asking me double negatives, why is my life always bad, why is there always something wrong with me, why does this, how about just say, what is right about me? Everything is right about you, Carrie Ann. You worry too much. Are you Capricorn? Tell me what you are. Are you a Capricorn? Yes, Katie, preach on Foxhole Prayers. Hell yeah, you got to preach on them. Because that's the only time, Miss Carrie Ann, you're in Scotland. Oh, I love you. 555, when I wake up. I told you I was going to do angel numbers, and I didn't even get my book out on them. Well, that's terrible. I'm sorry. We'll do it Wednesday night. I promise this time. I'm going to write it down. Raina, hold me to that. Hold me to it. Should I stay put or push the issue of going back to New York? Well, you're divided. You want to go back, but the other people don't. Yes, Nora. I don't think he's... I think he's still alive and well. I just don't think he's where he should be. Yeah. Ha! Christy, Brittany, you see your number, birthday, 9/11 on the clock all the time. 9/11 was the day of September 11th, but it doesn't mean that for you. If you keep seeing the repetition of your birthday, it means that you had bucket lists that you have not accomplished or started to work on yet. So it means you have things in your life you were supposed to do that is in your programming to do when you came here, and you haven't started them yet. Hi, Susan. Kirsten, I'm about to chew this comment up. Y'all be ready to heart, share, comment, or just get the hell off, because I'm about to tell people. Kirsten, you want to ask me, will I ever be good enough for my husband? Let me tell you the truth about that, honey. Hell no, you're not going to be good enough for him, because no damn body's good enough for him. Because you know what? The funny thing is, no one ever has been good enough, and no one ever will be good enough, because that's garbage from the start. What the hell? Does he have to be good enough for you? Why are you not good enough? Because you're not the maid? He didn't marry no damn maid. He married a wife. He better put her beside him, not behind her. Okay? And he didn't marry no damn cook. He could have went and married the colonel if he wanted some good chicken. He did not marry the maid. He didn't marry a damn babysitter. He married a wife. Somebody to treat like a goddess, and a precious one at that. And if you think you need to be good enough for your husband, I need to upgrade your husband a little bit to 2.0. Will you ever be good enough for your husband? You already were. If you got to ask me that, let me ask you, is he ever going to be good enough for you? He doesn't have a little 5 o'clock shadow, little beer gut, little tools over, little shed over the tools, huh? He don't snore. He just eats perfect. He just walks on water, doesn't he? I'm so glad you were carving the pumpkin. Yeah, you're too good for him. What in the hell? You are a goddess. You chose... Okay, you're telling me you swore off all other men. Have you looked at the damn good-looking men in this world? Seriously, I'm not even trying to go there, but you swore off all other men for this one joker, and you gotta live up to him? Are you kidding me right now? Are you kidding me? Have you seen the men out there? Do you look at them calendars? You swore off all other men for that guy and you may not be good enough? The hell, I am not the one. I'm not the one. No, Susan. Repeating numbers are always angel numbers. It's how your guides and angels contact you. Because they can't just say, hey, dummy. Because we don't listen to nothing. It seems like since my dad does, everything went to hell. Since your dad died, everything went to hell? Well, he didn't, honey. He was a good man. And maybe you need to go ahead and send that trash bag back to the garbage truck. Why do your ears ring when you burn sage? Probably because your angels already give you downloads and they're just clearing out all the garbage you've listened to in your real life. Yes, yes, Nora, you will. All your energy is rubbing off on her now. Breathe, babe. Sending good vibes and love. I've always been into healing ever since I was a young child. I was always into the Native American culture because my grandmother used to tell me that she was born on an abandoned Indian reservation, that we had Indian blood, and whenever I had a scrape, I would grab the aloe plant and place it on my cuts. I had an out-of-body experience after my grandmother passed in her room, came to me, I was scared shitless. Don't be scared. There's so much, come on now, you guys gotta know there's more than this. This is just a really three-dimensional reality. When we have so many dimensions, we're only in a three-dimensional, that's like going back to Nintendo when we have VR. We really don't live in very many dimensions. We're pretty stuck in these three heavy ones. Think about it. You gotta know there's more dimensions than just this. Don't be scared, love. That would be nice if they did. How can I help my stepdaughter? Misty, you can't help somebody that don't want your help, love. You wasting your energy. What you need to do is send that child some Reiki. Not even a child, but You need to send this lady, this girl, some Reiki energy, which is unconditional love energy, that you accept her decisions, even if they're mistakes. That's the best way to help people. Hi, Aaron. Hi, Misty. Hi, Valerie. Yes, Miss Bree. Bree is my wife. She knows. You guys know, if you're going to label me as whatever. I can't even believe these labels now. They got transsexual, straight sexual, homosexual, pansexual. I don't even know. Food sexual, like you in love with your food. I don't know. My ear. Okay, how's my dad's health? My ears keep getting plugged and he can't hear very well. He's got allergies bad and he gets drainage down his ears and down the eustachian tubes, and it shows me like a scratchy throat as well and a little bit of a... You need to get him on allergy medicines. You worried you'll never be a grandma. You hope your granddaughter... Are you kidding me? You're worried about something that ain't even happened, love. You can have my kids. They ain't got no grandma. You want some kids to spoil and love up? That's all you gotta do. Visit once a year. I'll come in the summer. Send them some birthday cards. Send them some cards. Scribble your name in there. $20 minimum. I got 4 of them youngins you can have. You can be a grandma. Good God, my kids don't got no grandma. You can have some. There's kids in the world need a grandma everywhere. Are you saying the mandala effect is real? Yes, Amelie, absolutely. Will I find a mate again? Honey, a mate is just somebody you make. A mates ain't hard to find if you're a woman. You can just go out and flaunt like a fish lure and sling around little shiny stuff, and you can attract the whole school of mates. It's partnering you want to find. Nessa, you have no energy at all. Weak, fatigued, scared to go to the doctor. Okay, wait a second. I'm about to call you out, Nessie. You have health problems. You list them. Weak, dying. You're dying. You have no energy. You're very weak. And you're fatigued. You have all this shit going on, but what you're scared of is the damn doctor? Are you kidding me right now, Nessa? Are you seriously kidding me right now? All the things that you just named, you think you may be dying. You gonna die, but you're scared of the doctor. What is the doctor gonna do to you? It can't be no worse. He don't follow you around fatiguing you and scaring you, making you feel like you're gonna die. So no, you need to go to the dang doctor. Are you kidding me? Tell that anxiety to take a hike. That shit ain't even real. It's real, but it's not real. You know what I'm saying? Carrie Ann, yes, I am a Capricorn. Of course you are, Carrie Ann, because you worry too much, baby. Quit trying to predict the future. Just let it. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Do you think it will be soon, because I am thinking of filing a missing report? Go ahead and file the missing persons report. You should go ahead and file all that. And that way he knows you love his stupid self. But when he shows back up with him and his junky friends, you're just going to be mad as hell. That's all that's going to happen. Huh. Missy said, you were saying all this stuff I just learned this year. Yeah, well, I just started cussing. So... You're like a big sister I always wanted. Well, you're like a little sister I always wanted, so I'll take that, Nessie. Thank you. Maria, I'm lost. Did I take the right path? Well, sweetie, you just told me you're lost, so how can that be the right path? Okay, so you're lost. I'm lost. Did I take the right path? Yes, you did take the right path, but you need a higher perspective on that path, okay? Hi, Amanda. I'm doing good. Yeah, please adopt my kids and be a grandma. They could use it. They need someone to take their side. Like, we need a grandma that takes our side all the time. I'm like, well, when you find her, let me know, because I hope she adopts me, too. I miss my grandma, too. I love her. If we ever have a session, I will tell you the full story. She was a Catholic who believed in purgatory. I ran... out the door during the out-of-body experience, and I ended up in a different dimension. Yep, that happens. I jumped over a rusted gate. Everything was gray. As I kept walking on the road, I saw other people, but they couldn't see me. It was, yep, it's like they were living their lives, but they weren't alive at all. I ended up falling back into my body. Such an odd experience. I've never had another one like it happen again. Well, I certainly hope not. That's enough to write a story on. You said if we ever have a session, you would tell me. That's just not how it works. If we have a session, I'd probably tell you. But I love that you shared this awesome story. And purgatory is a Catholic belief that goes back to the early church, and unfortunately, there is truth to it, but there is also a falsity to the reality of what purgatory was. They took the word Sheol, right? Sheol. Okay, you see it in the Bible, S-H-O-E-L. Sheol was meaning a time of place without a determined ending. So they just thought that that meant forever and infinity. It does not. Sheol means a time of a certain time that has not yet been determined, which depends on the person. If they shoot themselves and they were jerks all their lives, they may have to be there longer to learn their lessons and review their life. But if they were able to learn their lessons quicker, guess what? They move up, okay? That story doesn't really surprise me. How do I study and get more into understanding my empathic side? You wait until the classes come out, but you know what? As long as there's a great big universe, you'll always be able to find teachers. All right, let's see. Hi, Mackenzie. Hi, Christina. Missy, what's the government hiding in lockdown? Oh, God. A lot. And they always have, and they never will stop. Hi, Julie. Why don't you say hi to everybody instead of nothing for me? Don't be a sad sack. Don't be a bad sport on this channel. A friend who crossed over in 2009 has been on my mind lately. Does she have a message for me? Yes, Vicky. She's just talking about you being in good health and you being alone and kind of being by yourself. So it's important that you know that she's around you, supporting you. What's the government hiding? Let's see. Aliens, Bigfoot, lockdown, JFK. What else? Giants. Well, there's a lot to add there. I mean, anybody want to jump in? What's the government hiding, you guys? Let's throw it in there. Area 51. I feel like I've been surrounded by others who have gifts, and they have been telling me the things I needed to hear. Y'all are special. Amen, Miss Kenzie. Miss Kenzie, girl, I haven't seen you in months, and yes, you are. Yes, Carrie Ann, your dad is around you. Everything is so true, Deborah. Yes, the Anna, yes, yes, Missy. All right, Katie says, of course, I am awakening and learning to love myself first and being happy with me. I will never meet others' expectations, but that's okay. I have God and I am unique. Well, the thing about other people's expectations is they're bullshit. Let me say that in the most spiritual way. The thing about other people's expectations is they're completely and totally fabricated. And when I talk like this, you'll believe me. They're bullshit. Everyone's expectations of you are illusion. They're not real. They're only real to them, but you not knowing that they're real makes them not as real in your astral plane.
That's good.
Adenochrome. There we go. Thank you, Emily. So gross. Feeling lost, Julie. You're not lost. You're found. What are they not hiding? Yeah, I mean, exactly. Why do you think they cut the military's hair? Why do you think they shave their head and feed them salt in their food? Saltpeter, actually. Why do you think they put actual things inside of their diet? Why do they shave the head? It's because it takes away their sensitivity and intuitiveness. It makes them easier for mind control. Illuminati, thank you, Nora. Ha, Nicole, I miss you. I love you. Thanks for telling me that there's a small boy on the other side for me. Well, there is, and he loves you. I can't answer that one question, Miss Misty. That's a whole nother thing. Ever since I've been watching your lives, I've been feeling this sense of living my best life and working on my emotions. I'm about to pin your comment forever and ever. I'm going to pin it. And I'm going to copy it to my clipboard, and I'm going to write it on the mirror, and I'm going to put it on my wall, and I'm going to send... Look at these little hugs I just sent you. Everybody just heart the hell out of this comment, because I'm so happy. Listen to what our sister said. Ever since I've been watching your lives, I've been feeling like this sense of living my best life and working on my emotions. Thank you, Jesus! That is... Praise God. Hallelujah! We need to give this up. I need to get so excited right now. Just starting. See, look at the tribe. We love you. That is the true work. That is the work. That is the work. Just getting started in my inner journey. It's a journey and it has just begun. I'm working on myself and I'm trying to gain understanding that there is no perfect day. My work is done. You basically just did my job for me. It is a blessing to even have one easygoing day. Hell yes, it's... Yes, Brittany. I just want to give you the pebble from my hand. The student has become the teacher. The student has become the teacher. Here you go. You just got it. You just got it. Love how sassy you are tonight. Well, they took my page away. And I loved my page, and I worked hard for my page, and they took it away, and I'm mad. And I'm mad as hell. And I'm just gonna be sassy. I'm gonna be a sassy Southern psychic, just telling people how it is. I have two kids, and my son looks just like my dad, and I know I will never meet them, but I try so hard, and I feel like it's not good enough for self, so I keep striving for better, but I will find the best for me. Kirsten, this is illusion. There is nothing wrong with yourself. You don't need to be good enough for yourself. Actually, you're too damn hard on yourself. And if you just realize what a beautiful goddess you actually are, you would embrace your life, embrace everything about you. This and everything else would be perfect. And you'd learn to love yourself for what you are. Because you don't have to live up to nobody's standards. And you need to let go of your own standard. You're lovely, super different, and super special. Aw, unicorn head. Thank you for that unicorn head, Jake. I had an interview and got the job today. I told you, Kenzie, I'm finally on the path to happiness. I was in a dark place before. Okay, baby, let me just tell you, little sister, don't think that job is your happiness because that's just one more addition to happiness. But that way you don't wrap yourself up in something that can be taken away. Are you LMAO? Aw, laughing your apples off? Aw, that's so cute. I love watching your videos. I know, I like to watch them too. I can't believe the stuff I say. Karen says, why did my mom wait till I left the room to pass on? Because you were hanging on to her. What do you want her to do? Die right in front of you? No, they always wait till you leave because they're like, damn, I've been waiting 24 hours for her to go get a drink of water. Like, I wish she'd just go to McDonald's already. I gotta get out of here. I got a date on the other side. Ha! No, Nicole, you're not there yet, but give yourself a minute, you will be. Amen and amen. Does Chellen have something to tell me? She passed 10-6. Nora, you have gifts and you keep attracting. Are you a Pisces? What in the world are you? Are you like a Cancer Pisces something? Because seriously, you are attracting like losers, users, and abusers, and you give way too much, and you expect nothing in return. And there's spirit all around you and has been since you were a kid, but you block that stuff out quicker than turning off the sixth sense. Ha! Yes. When my mother passed, she told me both of my brothers, she loved them, but nothing to me, and I was taking care of her every day. Why? Because she is mean. What? It's mean as hell. What do you mean? Okay, slow it down, Sunshine. I don't need to be psychic to tell you your mom wasn't the nicest woman to females. She favored your brothers over you, and she was treated the same way. Your mama was being mean, but it's okay. She loves you now. I love your sassy side. Yes, he is, Margarita. I love the one tribe. I can't wait to get our clothing. Look at this, Raina Teller. You're a beautiful goddess. You are. My God, you're a beautiful goddess. I'm telling you, you need to live in your power. Live in your freaking power, please. Hi, Michaela. I'm just screaming, but ignore that. Just listen to the other stuff I say. It's pretty profound every once in a while. Love it when you tell it like it is. Yes, please. I like that ask a psychic. I think I'm going to say that from now on because that just sounds like a freaking funny blurb. I may be psychic, but yeah. It hasn't been easy with the anger and sadness. Oh, this is my profound girlfriend. Okay. I think this girl might be my girlfriend. I mean, you hear that, wifey? My wife? I think Brittany might be my girlfriend now. Let me tell you, it hasn't been easy. I struggle with anger and sadness, but I just got into doing something self-cleansing, which is meditating and fighting these negative thoughts. Oh my gosh. You're like a mental ninja. You like a warrior is what you are. Let me tell you what you need to do. So it says here, you're cleansing and fighting negative thoughts. You can't fight a negative thought with... I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing with you because I tried the same shit. It don't work. You can't fight anxiety. You can't fight negative thoughts. You can't fight negative people. Nayama number one, nonviolence. Accept what is, then you suffer less. And when you let the negative thought pass by, attaching no emotion to it, then you have received the answer. Okay? All right. Who's going tonight? Well, it's okay. Look, there's more of us. We can be a big tribe. It's okay. One last question. Does my dad have anything to say to me? Yes, he loves you, and he thinks you're a little goddess, too, and you need to start acting like one, Miss Kirsten. And you have a son, because he's talking about being around your son. Or I might be your grandson, but I feel like it's your son. This tribe is awesome. I'm glad I found you. I'm glad we found you. You have lit up my heart tonight. Aww. Well, lighty, lighty, one word from my sister. She loves you, Deborah, and she's proud of you, and she says don't get sucked into the politics. You've been really getting down about that. Good night, Wendy girl. Tina says, any guidance on if I find Mr. Wright? Well, if there's one that existed, tell me the factory, because I'd like to get me a model. No, I'm just kidding. I say yes, when you're Mrs. Wright, you'll find Mr. Wright. You don't find Mr. Wright when you're still battling your own demons and depression. It's when you're in the right frame of mind that you attract those of like-mindedness. Hi, Lori. I wish he was still here too, Tanya. Carrie Ann, you're just killing me over there in Ireland. I mean, Scotland. I love you, though. Does my dad have anything for me? I found him dead. Those two comments should never be posted together. Does he have anything for me? I found him dead. All right. I love you so much because you're a sweet angel. Your dad says he's sorry for how you had to find him, but it wasn't his choice. And there was things that... He just regrets it. He regrets a lot of things. There was a lot of decisions that weren't made in the right way, and there was a lot of, like, influence of alcohol or whatever. He says he loves you, and he hopes that you can heal from the experience, and I can help you with that. Can you capitalize goddesses, please? It's with a capital G. It's G, capital G-O-D-D-E-S-S. I can't wait for the energy clearing tomorrow. You're on fire tonight. I know, right? I didn't work. I don't work. I have the whole week off. Look at this little... She's so cute. Look, I'm just sparkly because I have no... Thank you, Sunshine. Thank God I found your page. Yes, I'll thank her as soon as I talk to her. I'm just kidding, guys. Kind of. It doesn't matter. Don't react to the negative thoughts. Let them pass through and continue on your path. I've been attracted to you... The first time I saw you do a live with another sister who lost her husband. See, I love that. Don't react to the negative. No, baby, don't react. You can let the negative thought just pass through your mind. Just like that blimp. Remember that old Goodyear blimp? It might pass really slow and be kind of fat and awkward. And you might just notice it. But at the same time, you don't attach an emotion. You just let it roll on by. I know, right, Lucy? My son was my dad's world. He always wanted a boy, but he got me. No. Oh, God. Kirsten. God dang it, Kirsten. You're the reason I started the One Tribe Foundation. Because can someone please sponsor this girl for an energy clearing? Can we please do a GoFundMe right now and raise $120 for this girl's, this lady, this sister? She needs an energy clearing so bad. I need to go in and reprogram that old operating system to update it into the positive so you can see your... See, you just told me your dad didn't want you. He always wanted a boy, and you're not a boy, but he got me. Lord have mercy, child. God didn't make no mistake on you. God did not make a mistake on you. He made you perfectly. He said we are wonderfully and perfectly made. The universe has no mistakes, Kirsten. You're amazing. Michaela, where should I go with my life and career? I thought I planned it all, but it just feels wrong. If you hate what you do, go the other direction. There's got to be something. That means you did it for other people. You don't do what you're truly passionate about. When I came across your lives, I lost two people close to me, my older two daughters, dad, and my boyfriend both within a week. As of now, I feel like I am not lost in an emotional cloud anymore. Amen. I'm still I want to put this phone down. I've been holding it and charging it the whole time. Let's put this thing down. Oh, Lord, thank you. Woo! All right, give me a second. Okay. But I'm still working on trying to control my anxiety, as it's been a struggle my whole life. No. You don't control anxiety, or it controls you. I'm going to teach you guys, when we start doing the One Tribe page, I'm going to start teaching you guys small clips and videos about anxiety. And I think what I'm going to do is start having an anxiety class, which will be a Zoom class, and I'm going to teach you tricks, tips, and techniques for controlling anxiety. Be non-reactive and stay in the light. Yes, a great book if you want to read it. I'm about to get up in the camera, get up all in your business. Here's one. This is one I recommend called The Yamas and Niyamas. This is my third copy of the book. And the first one, I already practiced these before I got this book. I learned them in a different, it wasn't this way. But this is a great way. So yamas are actually, it's like practices. This is practices and this is observances. And I observe and practice both of these. So, but the first niyama is nonviolence, but nonviolence against yourself. So nonviolence against yourself means not hanging on to or attaching feelings to negative and anxious feelings and observing them, okay? I'm happy he's on this other side. He cried all the time when he was on Earth. Yes. It takes two to make it right. Amen. Sometimes three. I mean, I'm not judging. I don't know what people are into. I'm just saying. I mean, like, you know, it could be like a triangle, maybe. Maybe like something going on. I don't know. Just saying, it could take three to make it work. Anyway. Let's see. Yep. Goddess. Yes. Yes. Kathy, he is happy. My sister, and you know I'm pacing with politics watching. Yeah, she just said. The first thing Glenda said was like, tell her to quit watching them damn politics and watch some Golden Girls and chill out. For like the first year I did readings, I had to literally watch Golden Girls every night because it's the only thing that would like chill me out and make me feel good. Because I feel like I'm a mixture between like, I definitely have a little bit of two of them. Two of the characters, I feel like I'm like the mixture of the two. Goddess is, yes. Thank you. You miss him so much. He misses you too, Carrie. He didn't mean to make you feel that way either. I know you did hear that, but he didn't mean to make you feel that way. I would love to find another man to be in a relationship again. I'm not really the one to tell that to, but I mean, I can put a little energy out there for you. I mean, I'm just saying, like, I don't usually use it as a dating service, but if there's anybody out there and you guys know somebody for Janet, please let her know. You are awesome! That's okay. Sometimes. And sometimes not. I wasn't kidding about us being a nonprofit and raising money for scholarships for women that have been battered and abused and have negative mindset. I'd love to help them clear their energy. Man, look at this mop. Good grief. It's like a mop head tonight. Wait, you're broken beyond words. No, you're not. What are you saying? Over a man? You are not broken above words. Women stretch. We don't break. Okay, we don't even crack. We can figure it out. Don't worry. Hey, Mandy, I love you too. I know you need some Golden Girls. That's what's up. All right, you guys, I got some food waiting on me. Okay, I love y'all. It's been an hour. I love y'all. Please share this. Let's be friends. As I get the business page, I'm going to figure out what to do. Y'all, please follow me on that Instagram page that I'm working on. I am going to put my psychic kids up there. Oh, Lord. It doesn't get better. The more I mess with it, it just gets worse. So, Yes, Lori. I do hold on to negative emotions, memories of the very traumatic domestic violence that haunts me. Not as much since he passed. Well, Courtney, do this. Go to the One Tribe community page. Post a fundraiser for yourself, please, or somebody would like to do it for her. Set up a nonprofit. I definitely want you guys to be donating because I do all this for free. I don't need the money, but I would love to see the money go to where it needs to be. There are so many women that are in abusive circumstances right now. I would love to be able to do sessions with them, angel sessions, anxiety sessions, and energy clearings. And that's why I made it nonprofit, so we can help those other women to find peace, help, and hope, and healing in the One Tribe. So maybe, Bree, maybe we'll get you in charge of that. I think that'd be a good idea. All right, you guys, much peace and love. Remember, we're always better together. And until Wednesday, I'll see you guys later. God bless.